many teams have ever?
Four.
Four?
Four.
Oh man, that's really not a lot.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the?
Not nice! There's a giant head!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Leafs lose 3-2 in overtime to the Florida Panthers in Game 3 of their second-round matchup. The Florida Panthers take the 3-0 series stranglehold over the Toronto Maple Leafs. And after a two-day break between Game 2 and 3, there will be another two-day break. We had two full days to talk ourselves into the Leafs winning Game 3, and it'll be a 2-1 series, and they'll be right back in it. And we'll have another two full days to complete the Herculean task of talking ourselves into the Leafs being the fifth team to ever come back from a 3-0 deficit in a series. I'm gonna need my phone for this. I need my phone! Get in on playoff action and make your next bet with Sports Interaction. Round 1 was completely bananas. Upsets, overtimes, and the end of a 19-year-old drought. That was 8 days ago! Now it's round 2, editor's note, for now, and with Toronto and Edmonton moving on, the excitement is as high as ever! Every shot, every play, every decision is magnified! With competitive odds, the best live in-play, and more ways to get into the game than ever, visit sportsinteraction.com/SDPN and download the Sports Interaction app! But only if you're 19 plus, please play responsibly. Sunday! It is Sunday, May 7th! April 29th! They won the series against Tampa. And we all made videos of Tavares' overtime winner to the Titanic theme. And it was a very topical TikTok sound with Taylor Swift and something about April 29th. That was 8 days ago! I don't usually talk to very many people before I do these videos. But I got the feedback of some people whose opinion I value. Because I knew in my heart of hearts, I can't go through that game. I cannot break that game down. I cannot be like, here's what happened in the first, here's what happened in the second, here's what happened in the third, here's what happened in overtime. I'm sure I'll get to all of it. All I can do is talk from the heart and tell you how I feel. Now, I do have to withhold some things. Because if I tell you how I really feel, there will be no reason to watch Game 4, let alone my LFR for it. But here's what it is. The Leafs are down 3-0 to the Florida Panthers. 3-0. The 1942 Leafs came back from a 3-0 deficit in the Stanley Cup Final. I think it was the 1975 Islanders and Penguins series. There was a 3-0 deficit there. 2010, the Philadelphia Flyers came back from a 3-0 series deficit, but no worry, the Bruins went up 3-0 in Game 7 and blew that too. None of us remember that. Not a one. Because the next year, not only did the Boston Bruins go on to win the Stanley Cup, but in the second round, they swept the Flyers to do it! Imagine getting swept in the second round. So, like, all your demons are erased right there. And then the often forgotten one, the LA Kings, were down 3-0 to Joe Thornton, San Jose Sharks. And they came back, and they won it, and then won the cup. That's it. That's it. Those are the only four teams in the over 100-year history of the National Hockey League that have come back from a 3-0 series deficit. How we got here almost doesn't matter. It matters. But all you need to know, Wall, that was Freudian. All you need to know is the Leafs have to become the fifth team in over 100 years to do something. And let's say the Leafs do it. All right? Let's say the Leafs do it. We take the next all a Monday. Oh. All a Tuesday. Oh. And they have this habit of playing games at night all day Wednesday. Oh. Let's say all that time does the Leafs some good. They win game 4. Game 5 on Friday. Game 6 on Sunday. And I believe that makes game 7 on Tuesday. But, you know, knowing the NHL schedule for this round, I assume it's maybe next month. Something along those lines. If the Leafs pull off a miracle, they'll only be halfway there. No, you gotta save it. No, you gotta save it because it's not over. It's not over. You have to believe it's not over because it's very literally not over. They could. But that's not how any of you feel right now. Is it? I actually did get a text from someone who does believe that it's not over and just bless you. Bless you. There's no fan base like this on planet Earth. But it's so hard to not feel as let down by this team right now as I've ever been. Ever. 2021 Habs, that sucked. That was really bad. But it almost played into the cartoonishness of the Toronto Maple Leafs and this streak. And then last year, they just sort of lost a 7-game series to Tampa. Normally, there was a controversy in game 7. Wes, hey, Wes. How you doing there, Wes? Way to really dispel those myths there, Wes. 2-0. You're the best, Wes. But they had to say the handshake line quote and the respect in the handshake line. And I was like, oh, you didn't need to say that. Now there's no more silly curse. They won a series, right? They finally overcame and they won it. And now there's just this overwhelming feeling of not, oh, this team's cursed. They're just not good enough. Like, not even sort of close. No matter how close the games are, no matter what the deserved win-o-meter says. Now, there's time to change that. The Devils lost 5-1 in back-to-back games against the Rangers and then won 4 of the next 5. They got completely obliterated by the Hurricanes in the first 2 games of their series. And then the Hurricanes scored 3 shorthanded goals in game 3 and still lost 8-4 because the Devils are back. You can still come back. You can play better. But this tweet, I think, sent me over the edge. The guys who led the Leafs in shots tonight were David Kampf and Erik Gustafsson! What happened? What on earth happened? I don't care how good the Florida Panthers are, and take nothing away from the Florida Panthers. They've been good. They've been great, even. They look a lot more like the team that ran over the league last year, except they got a little bit of that playoff snarl. Everything that they lacked against the Tampa Bay Lightning in the second round last year, getting swept themselves. Ooh, they know the sting. They felt it, and now they're inflicting it. Take nothing away from the Florida Panthers. But Marner leading the league in scoring, Matthews, elite player, doing elite stuff at an elite time, Tavares we'll throw in there. Nylander finally had a complete effort and finally got a primary point at even strength. Where has it all gone? All of it! Kampf? Gustafsson? Kampf was the best player on the ice? No! We can't have the full conversation about the core. Because they're still in it. They're still in it. And I don't like using LFR videos to promote other LFR videos. But I tell you what. Leafs win game four and they make it 3-1. That'll be fun. That'll be great. Then we can chit-chat about a Leaf win. Which I always like to do. And I'm sure you always like to do. Unless you're one of the sickos from other fan bases who complain about the Leafs being the center of the universe and then come and watch me voluntarily. But if game four has a similar result to this one in that the Leafs lose, I'm gonna be volcanic. It's gonna be a problem. You give up a breakaway on a penalty kill. You screen your goalie, you have no idea where the puck is. And then you completely abandon Sam Reinhart in overtime. Just abandon up that shutdown pair has gotten murked. Just shredded by these Panthers. The Panthers know so much of the Leafs goes through Mitch Marner. He's not able to do a thing. Dude, the Panthers are playing the Leafs' top line like a concerto. They're forcing Michael Bunting to do all the work, and he can't do it. He can't do it. He shouldn't be doing it. He's supposed to be a complimentary piece to two elite players, but they're completely neutralized. Completely neutralized. One of their own players takes out their goalie. Joseph Wolf thrown to the Wolves. Here you go, kid. Let's start with a penalty kill. This team has two options for Wednesday. Two. That's it. That's all. Overcome and begin, not complete, begin something that could be special. Or number two, prove you are exactly what everyone has said all along. Questions. From Jesse Brooke, will the joke ever not be on us? Jesse, I can tell you this. The day the Leafs finally win the Stanley Cup and we're all at the parade, I guarantee you all the buses and floats break down. From Mahesh, say the Leafs win one round, but are swept by Florida. What happens to Dubas and Keefe? Whoa. Nope. We're not there. We're just not there yet. Oh, but when we do get there, oh, I wonder. Prongy, does God hate the Leafs? Oh, yeah, for sure. Why are the Leafs going to reverse sweep and erase the Sharks' choke job out of recent memory? I appreciate you trying to speak it into existence, but, some truly spectacular things would have to happen. The Leafs would... Game 4 would have to be their best game of the series, bar none. Ironically, Game 3, which was the one they came closest to winning, was probably their worst. And also, Florida would have to be fat and happy, which I think they already are. These guys are playing without a care in the world. They are laughing and giggling on the bench through the majority of these games. And they're going to be playing a Leaf team that's like just choking the life out of their hockey stick every time they take the ice. It just seems impossible. From Luke Fox, this is the Maple Leafs' first three-game losing streak since October 30th. was still on the team. Like, yeah. Oh. There's no other team on earth like you. None. You're something else. Oh, you scamp, you rascal. Oh, it was less than 2 weeks ago. Maybe they got it! Number five! You gotta be number five! Imagine the Paul Maurice thing. If they do it, that'd be so good. Oh, you ever just want to go to bed? That is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. It's not over, but the next 72 hours or so are going to be unbearable.